All right, guys, I think this will be the last pet battle that pops up for the day. Normally, I don't get three in a row. This one is in High Mountain, and it's called Tiny Poacher, Tiny Animals, and it's to defeat Grixis Tiny Pop. And this is a straight counter fight. First, he'll use an aquatic, so we'll be using any kind of moth, Alpha Strike, Cocoon Strike, Moth Dust. And then our other two is Little Ragnaros with Sulfur Smash, Magma Trap, Sons of the Flame, which is going to be the important one, and then another Zandalar Ankle Render with, you guessed it, Hunting Party and Black Claw. The other one doesn't fucking matter. So here we go.
Quickly, quickly! Hit the road!
There's nothing special about the fight, really. Like I said, it's really just a straight counter. There's no special things that you have to worry about. If your Moth Dust lands, it kind of becomes a bit tricky, but or if it puts him to sleep, because he'll pull out, I think, excellent. But and then you just swap anyways. Do be careful though with Mudslide. You can pull pets out that swap into it. It's kind of weird. He's dead next round. Oh no, he's not. Damn. So yeah, he'll swap him out. That's right, I remember. You want to Black Claw. He's gonna die anyways, which is fine. And then with Ragnaros, all you do is Sons of Flame. And because it adds 118 damage to every attack, he attacks 6 times, dealing double damage. Anyways, he's basically fucked. And you dodge all his attacks. He explodes when he gets low life anyways. So, and then at this point you can try to finish him off with him, but it may not happen. Interesting fact, Sulfur Smash is actually the strongest pet battle ability in terms of pure strength in the game. Well, you know. He's also the slowest. So, anyways, that's it. That's the fight. This is all my pet battles for today. If you like what I do, I love your support. I love hearing from you. Feel free to send me a message. Subscribe, like, comment. Do your usual shit. Talk to you guys later. Bye.